Okay, it's Flux here with SoundSecure.com. We got John from Teenage Engineering, and he's awesome, as I was just telling him, and he agrees. He's going to show us a little bit about the OP Lab, right?
Right.
And a little bit of the functionality, and also what the DIY aspect of this is. So can you tell us what you guys did here?
Yeah, okay. So this is the OP Lab, or OP Lab. It's like a super interface for everything, pretty much. You can connect three USB units here, anything that understands MIDI over USB, like our synthesizer, our computer, iPad, anything you like that speaks MIDI. Here's regular MIDI for regular synthesizers. Okay, this is not a regular synthesizer, but it is a synthesizer. And analog synthesizer, so it's CV input and output, two analog in, two analog out, and the sync for drum machines. So here on the analog inputs, you can also connect your own sensors, either that we sell, like this, flip, tap, and poke. Poke is a pressure sensor. Ah, there we go. So now I'm playing the synthesizer and using this as a mod wheel.
Yes. Are all of these separate pieces going to be sold separately?
Probably, yeah. And then we're also going to sell it, the whole thing, as a kit with a tray and the board and the sensors and some cables and everything.
The layout of this board looks very DIY. You're going to be having this set up so that people can create their own devices and connect into here, use modular synthesis, and yeah, plug right in. It's going to be able to control things in that way.
That's right. The CV inputs here, the analog inputs, can connect and outputs can connect to a modular synthesizer, for example, or you can connect them to these sensors. And it's we try to make it as DIY friendly as possible, so it's quite easy to make your own. This is just a resistor here that you can turn. And this will send MIDI, so it is equivalent of turning a knob on the synth here like this.
Now, have you guys, are you going to have like a user community area for programs that are set up with this and DIY setups?
Yeah, we're planning on making some tutorials of how to do your own things for this. We had another idea here about, we didn't have time to finish it, but this is a hard drive. And actually we turned this, the motor will output some digital pulses. And you can plug it in here in the digital port and use it to like scratch the tape on the OP1, for example, or send MIDI control change like that.
Okay, that's great.
Yeah, so if you really want to go crazy, you can even write your own programs for this. But it works standalone as well. You don't have to do much configuration, but we'll probably make an editor in the end if you want to do some more crazy setups.
Can you tell us a little bit about the shoe trigger?
The shoe?
Yeah, the shoe trigger looks fantastic.
Yeah. It is. These sensors are, the poke is a poke sensor. Okay. Tap is a drum trigger. The flip is a motion sensor.
Okay.
And we've also made a shoe, a TS1. Whoops. With a built-in wireless flip sensor.
Oh, it is wireless.
Yeah, it is wireless. It runs with batteries. Just stick it in here. You don't have to put this on your shoe. You can put it like on your hat or jumpsuit.
And it's motion sensitive.
Yeah, three-dimensional. So you can use it for, and you put a little expansion board here with a radio receiver. So you can modulate things with like the movements of your foot. Also use it for example, for tap tempo. If you're playing with a band and your drummer isn't very tight, you can.
And you can control modulation with it.
Yeah. You can use like the tap tempo to sync your drum machine to a live band, for example. Wow. But just.
That's fantastic. When will this be shipping?
In about 6 weeks. We're taking orders now. It's $299 for the board and the TBA for the whole kit.
For the whole kit. And you get the tray as well? Yes. Okay. Well, it looks fantastic, and we thank you for everything you're doing. You're awesome, and so is the products. So I'm very happy.
You're awesome, too.
Thank you.